Hey boy, let's make a Cajun red gravy. Or Cajun spaghetti and meatballs. So, what I've got down here, some oregano, some garlic powder, basil, Italian flat leaf, salt, black pepper, green onions, Parmigiano Romano cheese. Got some bread in there. And yeah, look, we ate at Tony's last night. I had some of that gumbo. I wasn't too impressed. It was too slimy. Had a lot of shrimp in it, though. Had one of them muffaladas, the best I've eaten. Very, very good. Got some pet milk, or evaporated milk. Pet's the brand. Yeah, pet the cow. Okay. I'll put that on that bread to moisten it. And that takes the place of the egg. All right? More pet milk is needed, I can see. Come on, y'all just all go in there. Over there. All right, so all these ingredients are going in, carefully measured out. And look, I got some cutting boards out, but look, I ain't using them. See, here's a clear one, here's a white one. I don't have to clean this paper plate. I can chunk it in the garbage can for the landfill people. The green onion is going in there. Now my and the Romano cheese gonna go in there too. Or should I say Dago cheese. We're gonna mix this all about, then we're gonna go get that grind meat that I got in the fridge and put it up in here. It's for the meatballs. Cajun meatballs. Why are they Cajun? Because they got green onions in them. There, that's Cajun enough for me and you. Ask one of my fans who's made this, because I've made this about at least 10 times on YouTube. And maybe they'll reply, because I've gotten rants and raves about how good this is. You won't go back to store-bought nothing no more. Grind meat, 80-20 ground chuck. This is 2.5 pounds of grind meat. Come on, go up in there, boy. Now we got to get all that mixed about really, really good for the meatballs. All right, let me do that. Now while we're wasting water for the people in California, look here on the end of this foil. It says push this tab in, and that keeps your foil roll from jumping out when you're pulling it and tearing it. Get in there, you snot, you son of a bitch. Yeah, you see, push here to lock the roll. Now, unwind, Mr. Roll. Well, give me no lip, because I'll jerk your ass out of there. Now, more landfill material. Okay, we're gonna shut the water off. Put the meatballs in here. Keep our hands wet. All right, just for the hell of it, slap your mama. Now, it's even more Cajun. All right, so I got these WAP meatballs on here. No, they ain't WAP, they Cajun, they JB's. And I got some smoked sausage. But I ain't put it on here just yet. I'm going to get this started in the oven. Now, you could deep fry them, but 80-20 got 20% fat in it. You really won't get the grease out. You don't want to put no more in there. So, do them in the oven. Works just fine. I'm going to put that sausage in after just a little bit because I don't want to get it overdone. And the meatballs, I made them kind of big. And look, you can crowd them on the baking sheet. Why? Because it ain't a damn cookie. It ain't gonna spread out. It gonna shrink. Boy, just stay stupid if you don't know no better. Fool. Now, I was studying an old recipe. Presto Giacomo spaghetti sauce. Handwritten by Mama Presto Giacomo herself. And this would take her about 6 to 8 hours to make. And one thing that she did, and I tried this last time I made it, and I didn't video it, so that's why I'm making this video. She used to take tomato paste and brown that tomato paste. Kind of like making a roux, but with tomato paste. So we're going to do that. I got some onions, got some bell pepper. We're going to start them sautéing with some EVOO. Then we're going to put that tomato paste in there. Look down there, boy. We're going to put that tomato paste in there and get that to browning too. And you can't stop stirring. It's like making a roux. And it adds a different richness to this dish. Pay attention, boy. Alright, hot pot, semi-clean stove. Some EVOO going in there. Get hot, boy. Really on a small burn. And I do that so I don't burn shit up. I'm bad about burning stuff sometimes. Alright, onions going in there. Bell peppers going in there. Garlic's gonna go in later. Alright, let's go ahead and taste that tomato paste. It's a store brand, don't matter, use what kind you like. Put it in there. And we're going to start this to browning. What do I mean by browning? Just cooking, boy. And that's going to sweeten it up. It's going to give it a sweeter flavor by doing that. You got to pay attention to this, though, boy, because you can burn the shit out of this. So this got to be stirred constantly. See, I got the fire on low. I'm fitting to crank it up after I get another pop. Let's whoop some garlic. And we're going to give it a quick mice up. All right, now here's that garlic. It's got to go in there too. Hence up. Oh, you stupid oven. That means the meatballs is just about ready. So we're going to let them saute in that tomato paste too. Brown up just a little bit. And that's not something that I normally do. I like to add liquid before. But this is semi-liquid. It's paste. We fit to pop it with a little bit of wine anyway. That tomato paste is all cooked up. And tasting sweet. Oh yeah, baby. Do you like it sweeter? Put some sugar in there.